Welcome. I welcome you all to the new session of the Mathematical Physics. In this session, we shall be discussing about the complex integration. So complex integration is very, very important from the integration point of view. Here, we shall be integrating the complex functions, and by the end of the complex integration, we shall learn how to integrate the complex functions where the limits will be from minus infinity to plus infinity. It would be on the real axis, it would be on the imaginary axis. So the complex integration would be very helpful in solving many complicated integrals. So let's learn how to solve the simple or the basic integrals. So here, the integrals will be involving a function fz and dz. So let us see how to solve these fz dz integral. See here, we will be having a function that is f of z and dz, and here are the limits of the function. That is, here the limits are given to be 1 minus iota and 2 plus iota. So 1 minus iota, 2 plus iota means that the limit, that the z value is having the limit of 1 minus iota or 2 plus iota. So it is having a real component as well as the imaginary component. Since we know that the z is equal to x plus iota y, we know that z is equal to x plus iota y, where our x is the real part and y is the imaginary part. So accordingly, the limits of x and y coordinates will be found out to be that for 1 minus iota, the limit is x equal to 1 and y is minus 1. Similarly, for 2 plus iota, the limits will be for the x-axis, it will be x is equal to 2 and y equal to 1. So from the limits, we can calculate the coordinates of x and y. And here the function is given to be 2x plus iota y plus 1 into dz. And since z is equal to x plus iota y, so for dz, we can write it as dz is equal to dx plus iota dy. So for dz, we are writing it as dx plus iota dy. So now we were given that we had to evaluate this integral along x is equal to t plus 1 and y is equal to 2t square minus 1. And another question is that we have to evaluate the integral along the straight line joining 1 minus iota and 2 plus iota. So let us see the first integral along the x equal to t plus 1 and y is equal to 2t square minus 1. So the first step, what we have to do, we have to first differentiate x and y, because we are given x is equal to t plus 1 and 2t square minus 1. So we differentiate x so that we can substitute the value of dx in dz. So x is t plus 1. So what we get dx is equal to dt. And for y is equal to 2t square minus 1, we can write it as 4t dt. So if we differentiate y, what we get dy will be 4t dt. So now we have the limits of x and y as x is 1, y minus 1, x is 2 and y equal to 1. Since we have to integrate along x is equal to t plus 1 and y is equal to 2t square minus 1, so we shall be substituting x, y, dx, dy, all in terms of dt. So here we can see, so when we have to substitute each and every variable in t, so our limit should also be tending in terms of t. So from the equations of x and y, we calculate the limits of t. So from this x equation, we calculate the t limit. So when we put x is equal to 1, we calculate the t is equal to 0. And when x is 2, then we get the value of t equal to 1. Similarly, from this y equation, we have the limit of t as when we substitute y is equal to minus 1, we get t equal to 0. And when y is equal to 1, we get the value of t equal to 1. So what we find that for both x and y initial limits, the value of the initial limit of t is 0 and the final limit of t is 1. So now we can substitute the limits of t. So here we have the limits of t as 0 to 1. For x, we have substituted t plus 1. For y, we have substituted t 2t square minus 1. Dx is dt and dy is 4t dt. So now our integral is in terms of t, and using the normal rules of integration, we integrate our expression, because now the integral is only in one variable, that is dt. So we integrate and we put the limits of t as from 0 to 1. So we get the answer as 4 plus 23 by 3 iota. So the second question was that we had to integrate the same integral over the straight line joining 1 minus iota and 2 plus iota. So when we integrate over this line, so first of all, what we want the equation of line. So we can find the equation of line from the two-point form equation. So I plot the coordinates of these two points. So I know that for 1 minus iota, the coordinates are 1 minus 1. And for 2 plus iota, the coordinates are 2, 1. So I have these two points. So I join it via a straight line. So using the equation of line for the two-point form, we know that the equation of line will be given by y minus y1 is equal to y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1 into x minus x1, where I choose my x1, y1 to be 1 minus 1, and my x2, y2 is 2, 1. So I substitute the values. So I get the equation of line to be y plus 1 is equal to 2x minus 1. And similarly, if I differentiate this equation, I get my dy to be equal to 2 dx. So I substitute the value of y and dy in this equation such that what I get my resultant in terms of x. So since my integral is now solved in one variable, that is in the terms of x, and I substitute the limits also of x. So x has the limits of 1 and 2. So I solve the integral. So I get a value of 4 plus 8 iota. So in this way, by using this concept, by putting dz is equal to dx plus iota dy, wherever we will get z, we will substitute x plus iota y. And we will try to convert it into one equation or in the one variable form. If we cannot separate it into one variable, so we will separate it into two variables, and accordingly we will substitute the limits of x, as also we will substitute the limits of y. So if we can convert it into one variable, so we shall be putting the limits of that variable and solve the integral. So this, looking at the next question, so what we have here, that we have to evaluate the line integral over C. So we have the function as 3x squared dx plus 2y dy, where C is the circle. Equation of the circle is given to be x squared plus y squared is equal to 1. And also the contour is taken in the counterclockwise direction from the point 10201. So first of all, if we draw the circle, we have this circle, and we know that it is counterclockwise or in the anticlockwise direction, and we have to integrate over this path, that is from 10 to 01. So what we find here, that we have to integrate in this first quadrant, and we know that the value of the theta that is varying here is 90 degree in the first quadrant. So we have this equation of the circle, that is x square plus y square equal to 1. And the radius, according to this equation, the radius of the circle is 1, because we know that the equation is x square plus y square is equal to a square or r square, where r is the radius. So radius is given to be 1. So if we convert our equation into the polar coordinates, so what we find, we have the equations here as x is equal to r cos theta and y is equal to r sine theta. And the limits we had to take, that from 10 to 01. So we have already discussed that the theta is varying in the first quadrant from 0 to pi by 2. So we differentiate our x and we substitute r equal to 1. So we get dx is equal to minus sine theta d theta, and our dy comes out to be cos theta d theta. So we substitute the values of x, y, dx, dy. And since the equation is in theta, so we substitute the limits for theta, that is from 0 to pi by 2. So we convert this equation here as this. So now we have this equation. So to solve the equation, we use its simple integral results or the formulas. So we substitute cos theta equal to m and sin theta equal to n in the respective integrals, and accordingly we have our dm to be minus sin theta d theta and dm to be equal to cos theta d theta. So the limits also is varying from, if theta is from 0, our m value chooses to be minus 0. Similarly, when theta is pi by 2, m is 0, and when theta is pi by 2, n is 1. So we substitute the limits of m and n. So we integrate our result, and on integration, what we get the answer to be equal to 0. So in this way, also you can find your complex integrals. Similarly, looking to another question, this is of the same type. Here again we have the equation of circle, that is x square plus y square equal to 1, taken in the anti-clockwise direction. So radius is 1. We make the same substitution, that x is equal to r cos theta, y is equal to r sin theta, and we substitute the values of dx and dy. So we get this equation. So what we get the equation as 3 sin cube theta with a negative sign d theta plus 2 sin theta cos theta. So for sine cube theta, we are using the trigonometry identity and we substitute it as 3 sine theta minus sine 3 theta by 4. So this is just the change that was taken here in this question. So for sine cube theta, we substitute as 3 sine theta minus sine 3 theta by 4. And then rest, we can solve the problem using the normal integral rules and answer equal to minus of 1. So we can solve our problems of the complex integration. Looking at the next question, so what we have here, we have the equation as 0 to 2 plus iota is the limit. The function is given to be z bar square. So just look at this part, it is z bar square. Z bar square means it is a complex conjugate function, and integral is over dz. We have to integrate over the line given to be equal to y is equal to x by 2. So when we are given our function to be z bar square, so we have to substitute the complex conjugate of z. Now, since we know that z is equal to x plus iota y, so what is z conjugate? So z conjugate is x minus iota y. The iota is replaced by minus iota in the complex conjugate. So it is z bar square. So here we have x minus iota y ka square. And just see here, it is dz. So for dz, we shall be substituting dx plus iota dy. We shall not be substituting dx minus iota dy. It is dz, so it will be dx plus iota dy. So we are given that we have to integrate over the line y is equal to x by 2. So we will find the value of dy. So dy will be equal to dx by 2. And the limits will be for x, because now we are trying to convert our equation in x variable. So we can see here that the real limit in the lower limit is 0 and the real limit is 2 here. So the limits we will be substituting for the x variable, so that the limits comes out to be 0 to 2. We substitute the value of y and dy, so we get x minus iota x by 2 whole square into dx plus iota dx by 2. So we simplify our expression, and this is normal integration. So what we get our result to be equal to 5 by 3 into 2 minus of iota. So we can solve our integral.